Rising from the Pacific like floating fortresses, the five islands that make up the Channel Islands National Park are worlds apart. Like the Galapagos Islands of South America, animals and plants evolved in isolation on the Channel Islands for thousands of years. As a result, over 150 unique species are found here, including the island fox, an animal found nowhere else on Earth. These islands also harbor some of the world's most well-preserved and sacred cultural sites, which shed light on the lives of the Chumash, a Native American group that thrived here for thousands of years. Santa Cruz Island, the largest of the islands at 96 square miles, boasts the greatest abundance of both biological and cultural diversity. But the island has also been the setting for a series of events that disturbed the balance of life and threatened the survival of the native inhabitants. Life flourished on Santa Cruz Island until the mid-1800s, when pigs and sheep were introduced by European settlers and eventually formed large feral populations numbering in the tens of thousands. Rooting and grazing their way across the island, these non-native animals destroyed the native vegetation. In their wake, they left bare ground that was easily eroded and colonized by non-native grasses and invasive weeds like fennel, which choke out native species. As a result, 9 plant species were listed as threatened or endangered. The archaeological remains of the Chumash Islanders also fell prey to the non-native animals. These animals rooted so deeply that they disturbed and desecrated sacred sites and destroyed their archaeological value. In the 1950s, the island was struck by another blow, this one from offshore. Historically, bald eagles were an important part of the Santa Cruz Island ecosystem, but their populations were heavily impacted by the insecticide DDT. The chemical was discharged into the marine environment and worked its way up the food chain, eventually reaching bald eagles. This caused their eggshells to be too thin and easily crushed, resulting in reproductive failure and the total elimination of bald eagles on the Channel Islands by the middle of the 20th century. With the bald eagles no longer a competitor, golden eagles from the mainland began to venture over to the island. Unlike bald eagles, golden eagles hunt terrestrial animals, and the feral pigs and native island foxes made for easy prey. Island foxes, a unique species found only on the Channel Islands, have long been the island's top predator, living without the threat of being hunted by other animals. But now, for the first time, the island foxes had become prey, and the results were catastrophic. As a result of golden eagle predation, the island fox population dropped from an estimated 1,500 foxes to fewer than 100, placing the island fox on the brink of extinction. For the island foxes, the bald eagles, and many other species, life on Santa Cruz had become unsustainable. There was little chance of the island recovering on its own. So the island's managing partners, the National Park Service and the Nature Conservancy, put together a multifaceted restoration plan built on science and long-term commitment. A plan to restore the island species and ecosystem was put into action, signaling a change from an era of island ranching to one of conservation and preservation of a national park. The first phase of the plan began in the 1980s with a program to remove the non-native sheep. Without the sheep, the island was granted some reprieve, a chance for vegetation to regenerate, for the landscape to stabilize. But non-native pigs continued to wreak havoc on the island's cultural and biological resources, ruining sacred archaeological sites, uprooting native island vegetation, and supporting golden eagles that in turn would eat the island foxes. So specialists were brought in to remove the non-native pigs and live capture and relocate the golden eagles to the mainland. Initiatives were also taken to restore the island fox population. Pairs of island foxes were brought into captivity where they were carefully monitored and bred to ensure the survival of the species. In 2006, as the last of the non-native pigs and golden eagles were removed, biologists began releasing the captive island foxes back into the wild. To re-establish bald eagles to their historic home on the islands, over 60 bald eagle chicks were released on Santa Cruz Island. And in 2006, for the first time in over 50 years, a bald eagle chick hatched on the island. The island's animals weren't the only beneficiaries of the healing ecosystem. native plants sprouted across the landscape, and the Chumash archaeological sites stabilized. Although the signs are hopeful, the National Park Service and its partners must remain vigilant in the coming years to ensure native species continue to recover and that the island is once again able to function as a self-sustaining ecosystem. Santa Cruz Island harbors some of our nation's most remarkable biological diversity. As a national park, we have promised to protect not only this diversity, but also the natural processes that sustain it. It's wild places like Santa Cruz that capture our imagination, that keep us connected to the natural world, and remind us how important it is to protect what remains of natural and cultural heritage now and for generations to come.